name is Tiana.
I'm Natessa.
I'm Aiden.
I'm Leah.
I'm Marina.
And I'm Leonardo.
And today our topic would be how social media affects our lives. So from my point of view, I see that social media is a very negative aspect of our everyday lives. Obviously, almost every single person in the US has like some access to social media through internet or their cell phones. And I believe that there should be laws, like not laws, but like some kind of like law enforcement or higher being of security that could kind of look over what we're doing, because it's like really affecting our everyday lives. Like not really like hardcore like communist China does, but or like North Korea, but just like some kind of like protection.
And what exactly do you want to, what do you want to be protected? Like what is a level of like, oh, we shouldn't have this?
Because obviously there are already lots of groups in the government that are trying to find those like child predators that like constantly go on like so many sites to find kids, or just like there are just so many people that like the internet is just like an open thing. It's just not like, you know, like protected. So that's why there are a lot of hackers that can just like constantly hack people and like internets and printers, et cetera, et cetera. So if you were to be able to put like more of like a bigger security system throughout like the entirety, like at like a federal level, then like there will be a lot more safety, like precautions. So like nothing bad, more bad things will happen, like cyberbullying, et cetera, et cetera.
In my opinion, I feel that that can cause more like the government to be involved in our personal lives, which I don't think feel like should be regulated. I feel like it should be free, and like there are small regulations that social media has, and I feel like putting like a higher power over it is just gonna cause like an invasion of our privacy.
I agree with that. I think like social media is like your own personal thing, and like people have control over like how much they want to put out there and like how much they want to be seen active. So I don't think like a federal law will necessarily help anything.
I agree with that too, because over time they could slowly take away our freedom by invading our privacy. They could take one step further by filtering many things, and we'll go ahead and lose our freedom over time if they keep doing that.
And I think it's just kind of impossible. I mean, in the sense that you can't really have jurisdiction over something like that, but like the FBI could already figure out whatever they want to do, or like what they want. Like, so they kind of have that control if it comes down to it. Like you said, like predators or like crime of any sort, they could do that if they want. So I think it's cool how it is.
Yeah, I see where you're coming from with the whole like negative like impact of social media, but I'm not sure if like the security might be like the biggest concern there. For me personally, at least, like what I think of when I think of like the negative influence of social media is like the influence it has like on an individual and like their well-being. So UPenn actually did a study where they picked 143 students and they limited their social media use to 30 minutes a day. And they measured their like degree of depression using the Beck Depression Inventory, which it basically gives you a score of like your depression level. So the score actually dropped from an average of 23 to 14.5. So I think like decreasing social media and like its presence is definitely gonna help, but I don't know if like laws are the way to do that.
On top of that, talking about a person's well-being, I think that like the first thing you do when you wake up in the morning is usually check your phone and hop on social media. And in that sense, I think you don't have the ability to formulate your own opinions about how you feel about certain things, because the first thing you see in the beginning of the day is another person's opinions about this, that, whatever. So I think it's intrusive to the fact that you can't really determine how you feel about something or how you feel about yourself, because the first thing you see is another person's opinion on something, and that's not how
I feel. Social media has had a big impact on us, because really in our personal daily lives, many people see, like for example, many social media platforms, they see what everybody's doing. So it's a great way that people hide their depression and really just want to post the good and never the bad. So it really lowers people's self-esteem.
Exactly.
I also think that people get like a lot of inspiration though. Like a lot of people get like employed, and like although they're like good and bad, I feel like it's just all on each individual like yourself to like see how much it affects your life. Like you should be able to control that.
Because anything in excess is obviously bad. So if you just lower it in the long term, like I think social media has done a lot for our society, and like we've been able to connect with people all over the world, and use it as a platform.
Yeah, definitely agree. Okay. Well, that is our little short segment on how social media affects our lives. Thank you so much for watching.